I've had to see the ugly side of the industry, which I still see all the time. But when you're 14, you don't know how wrong it is, and you let people get away with more than you should. Because being on stage alone is a hard thing to do. It's very vulnerable, it can be scary, it can be empowering, but it can also be very disempowering because there's so many people there who get to say what they want about you, and for some reason when you're a woman on stage, you're public property, you're not a human being at all. Yeah. And people take advantage of that. Waking up from the deep sleep. I grew up very religiously. My family were Hare Krishnas, and there are aspects of it that I love very, very much, and I owe a lot of my creativity to that. But there are also regimented gender roles. So from a very young age, those roles were enforced on me. There was never a moment where I thought that I like had the same freedoms as boys, because I didn't. But I also got angry about that pretty young. So I think it was good in a way, because I never got to be lax.
When you've had conversations with people about gender equality, what has that been like? And do you have any tips for our viewers?
I think the most important thing is making sure that the conversation is intersectional and includes all women, and includes people who are gender non-conforming. It needs to include women of colour, women from low socioeconomic backgrounds, women who are trans, women who are disabled, because usually the main conversation tends to revolve around a woman with privilege, a woman who tends to be white, who's like upper class, but that needs to expand, because, you know, if we're not fighting for all women, then we're doing it wrong. Everything I do is special.